We spend more than twice as much per person on healthcare in this country as the average of all other industrialized countries, yet we're the only one that doesn't have universal coverage. That's a national shame.
We're the only industrialized democracy that doesn't cover every citizen. That is immoral.
That's immoral?
Yes. To be a country this wealthy and be the only industrialized democracy that hasn't figured out how to cover everyone.
I think providing health care for people who can't afford it is something that most people do agree with. And I read somewhere, I think it was in the New Yorker, that 45,000 people die needlessly because they simply don't have access to health care. And that just seems so unfair and so undemocratic.
This bill is a fiscal fraud. I'd still vote for it because I think it's a good thing to extend benefits and to get start down the road to universal and because of the health insurance.
One way or another, public option or regulation, the government has to play a role.
I'm just telling you, we need to pass a bill that doing nothing is not only the worst thing we can do for the economy and the worst thing we can do for health care, it's the worst thing we can do for the Democrats. And don't you think the Republicans don't know it.
That is the voice of God, sir. David Corn, that is the voice of God because it's the voice of truth and experience. I completely buy what he said, completely.
The idea that this is a Democratic bill, you know, that this is some left-wing plot, some government takeover that they're going to ram through the Senate is the part that's the problem. This is a very centrist-leaning conservative health care reform bill.
There is already an email circulating that I've received today that reads simply, in lieu of flowers, pass health care reform.
If they're with Democrat Martha Coakley, they get health care reform. If they go for Republican Scott Brown, it's deliberate, premeditated murder for health care.
On a personal note, you said last night the first call you made after your victory was to Ted Kennedy's widow, Vicky. How comfortable was that for both of you, knowing that you plan to do everything you can to derail what Ted Kennedy called the cause of his lifetime, which is health care reform?
How do you think that Senator Ted Kennedy would feel about your election?
Well, obviously.
Think he'd be disappointed?
They've waved signs likening President Obama to Hitler and the devil, raised questions about whether he was really born in this country. Add it all up, and some prominent Obama supporters are now saying that it paints a picture of an opposition driven in part by a refusal to accept a black president.
I think some of the people are upset because we have a black president.
Harry Reid said, Republicans are on the wrong side of history when it comes to this health care bill. And very soberly yesterday, he compared those who opposed health care to those who opposed civil rights legislation.
The Republicans lie. They want to see you dead. They'd rather make money off your dead corpse. They kind of like it when that woman has cancer and they don't have anything for her.
And there are people that are actually trying to derail health care in order to take down Obama, even if it means half the country dies.
The Republican strategy was don't show your ugly faces tonight.
Right.
Today they kept all the crazies.
Well, they led with Lamar.
All the crazies were in the closet. Look at these terms. Start over, clean sheet of paper, scrap the bill, step by step, repeated like robotics. This is what it must be like in one of those North Korean assembly meetings
remember,
where they all get together before the dear leader.
Unfortunately, at the moment, though, health care is being held hostage by partisanship.
Governor, do you believe that the Republicans are playing politics here at the risk of people's health care? Is it upstaging the need to help people right now? Is this getting to be a little bit of a reckless situation?
This is really all or nothing for the sense of his power, for his legacy. He's invested so much in this first year. You've got to get this for him.